is the result always coming. That is different circumstances. That is always changing. But it's the way you do is your focusing. No? So then slowly, then you use meditate every day, or I don't know how many time you have, but I think at least if you can do 5 minutes, you know, 5 minutes every day in the morning or afternoon when this is you can deal with your time. Maybe for me, this best time is in the morning when you wake up, and this better when you have time. Just as you don't need some cushions or some meditation room. If you have, of course, you can go, but it's not necessary. And you, everybody have bed, no? You stand up in the bed, and before you have to go to the toilet, you can go. And if you're not, and then you just, you know, wake up and stand in your bed, just sitting like this. And the 5 minutes, completely full. You know, that your mind is very calm, very relaxing. Then the stress is gone. Stress, you know, sometimes we a little bit stress, you know, kind of, you know, and this is gone. And then slowly his mind is more and more relaxing, more and more calm. And then we can get to really enjoy our life, you know. And then if you can do in the morning, before you completely stand up, or before you go to bed in the night, in the evening. Yeah? If you go to bed, this is we have time. No? We don't need to go to immediately. You don't need, yeah, if you want.
And do we close the eyes, Rinpoche, in the Tibetan, in this way? And do we focus when we sit on the bed on the breath or the part of the breath? Can you explain?
Before you go to bed and you meditate, sitting, sit down. This, I think maybe it's for here, close eyes is better. But when you meditate as Dzogchen, you have to open. That is a little different method. But this is completely different way as Buddhist, you know? So you have to open the close and you have to open the eyes and you look at through the nose and in front of you. But for us, this beginning is a little difficult. But when you close eyes, you have more chance to little bit calm down, relax. What I said also, when you close, so we have different chance to focus in the color, what you see in the eyes, right? Everybody can see something when you close. There is sometimes red, yellow, blue, pink, whatever. Yeah? What you see doesn't matter. You can focus in the color, what you see, or white, or you know. And this is focus. At the same time, you enjoy in there. But then slowly you recognize you don't attachment to the color. You know, slowly, this is the next step. Huh? And so this is the how you do. And then maybe your question is, and we go to sleep, this is, I said, is, you know, complete. Then another method, you go to sleep, if you don't want to focus in the color, and then you sleep in that side, in the right side, lying this, and this is, a, you can say, kind of yoga dream. Yeah? Yoga dream. And you sleep in that side, you know, completely relaxing. And the hand, the left hand is put in your hip, you know, you're sleeping. Your mind is completely relaxing, body is relaxing. And then you go to sleep, and then next morning you wake up, it's the same, your body is so fresh, and so healthy, and so powerful, and so, you know, and that is you can eat.
And during the day, Rinpoche, because you sat on the breath, so maybe for the people who begin, mm-hmm. do we focus on the in-breath, out-breath, but mm-hmm. then you start to think, and or a part of the breath, out-breath, or mm-hmm. only in-breath, what do you recommend?
I think during the day, I think almost everybody busy, no? I think only we have the time in the evening and the morning, I think, most people. Anyway, so if we have, if you have time and during the day, then you can practice as a breathing meditation, and we do in this, I think this morning or yesterday. Okay, breathing meditation, yeah? Breathing meditation is very, very, in fact, and very moment, you know? Breathing meditation, if you breathe in, if you want breathing meditation, you see, when you are beginning or, you know, I think not only beginning, but breathing meditation is very useful. Even you are a little bit more experienced about meditation, and breathing meditation also gives you planning, which is giving and taking. Yeah? Which is giving is whatever I do, all the virtues to give to the others, all the same thing. What they need food, they need clothes, they need mind, which is spiritual way. It's all what they need, I give. That is the mind and mentally, right? Then when I take and breathe in, I take all the same things, have sufferings, difficulties, or problems, I take. So this is exchange. You know? Very powerful practice if you do that. But some people don't like that because they think, oh, then I get so much bad energies. Oh, God. They think. But this is the reality, ultimate reality. It's not. If you do that, you have so much positive energy because your motivation and you do for so many beings. All the sentient beings, all the people, the positive energy come to you. You have very little power, energy, good. Then maybe some people meet you and you can bless them because your motivation is really pure and compassion, love. Because without compassion, love, we cannot take in giving, no? So the breathing, beginners, and you can breathe, breathe out, focus and breathe. Yeah, very easy. Everybody breathing, no? But breathing is always moment. We cannot breathe for tomorrow, you know? It's now. We have to do now. As long as we are alive, we breathe, no? So, we're breathing. Breathing out, breathing in. When you're breathing out, you focus, you breathe out, goes to from the nose or mouth, they going back to in your stomach. You follow, your mind is follow your breathing. That meaning, this is focusing your mind. You know? Breathing in, breathing out, breathing in, breathing out. You know? That is training. Yeah? Very easy, easy meditation, beginning. Yeah? So this is not difficult. Okay. Then this is means is your mind is more stable. There's so much we have, the head is full thinking, and then we focus one breathing out, breathing in, then the mind is more focused, one point, and then slowly our mind is stability, not shaking. You understand, right? Not so much changing. So that is the, how we have the, how we can do, yeah?
Is it time for questions, Rinpoche, or maybe break?
Okay, you can ask questions, yeah? Then we have, I think, 10 minutes, we can break.
Then we have 15 minutes break, so when we end here, the 5 minutes.
So maybe we continue now and then we break till lunch. Maybe that's better. Because some people have to prepare the tables there.
Say it again, Paul.
Maybe we continue now with some questions answers.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have break. And then after the break directly we do the lunch.
Oh, okay.
Because now it's already 11:20.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ah, okay.
Question. Yes. You told me to focus on an object, to meditate that way. But when I start doing it, I have all these questions. Do you keep the object clear? Does it go away? I don't know how to focus my mind when I do that. So.
Is the object of your mindfulness or your mind, whatever where you are, in front of your eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Even you go to to the maybe in the park, you know, in the, and then you sit in the deep, couch or the chair, and then you see and maybe in the road, you know, there's people walking,
mm-hmm.
or sometimes in the ocean, in the lake, or in the river, you know, and there you can focus in the water also. The water is a little bit moving, no? And sometimes. And then you just look at the water, focus, and then how many minutes, 5 minutes or 10 minutes, and then you can go to home, for example, yeah? And then in the home, you have no water, right? So then your object, you have to change, yeah? Change again, then maybe in the table you have a cup or glass, and then you can look at your glass. That is your object, this moment.
Mm-hmm.
That means the object is not important. The object is not important, right?
Mm-hmm.
The very important to how you can focus in your mind. That is the meaning, right? You understand, right?
Yes.
The object is, it doesn't matter which flowers or butter or
mm-hmm.
water or mountain.
But the problem is once you start focusing
mm-hmm.
and you're looking at an object, the object blurs, and you can
what?
Choose the object blurs, like it isn't clear anymore.
Yes.
Do you keep the image clear in mind or do you then blur away?
Yeah. It's, if your image is like Buddha,
mm-hmm.
you know, if you, this is kind of like visualization sometimes, no?
Mm-hmm.
And then you have to make it clear, the object, because the Buddhas have some kind of symbols in the hand, you know, symbolics in the hand, and his face, or, you know, the all the things, for example, the Gurupadmasambha, or maybe the Medicine Buddha,
mm-hmm.
and they look very precisely to look at this, the images, and then where you have the images in front of you, you can look at the images, then you just focus to there. Without the images is in front of you, then you focus, you close, like you imagine.
Okay.
You know, picture you bring in your hand, like this, and you close eyes, and you're focusing in there. That is a kind of visualization, but it's a little different, right?
Mm-hmm.
Not like before, it's one point focusing, but this is a more. Then I think this is, I think then direction of the Buddhism way, where, because of the visualization as Buddhas, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that is, the focusing, whatever you can focus. If you are Buddhism also, you can you can get in paper, and you put in your wall, and in front, just look. Or the without is you can say by your mouth in your speech. You can say it. And you can say it because this is is very easy, no? There's no difficulty. Everybody can say When if you focus on the then you can say before you how the is look like. You know, this is important because the object.
Mm-hmm.
And then you just close eyes, before you have already you saw the then now imagine that the is coming to in your head or your eyes when you close eyes. And then now you say eyes, you know, And then the visualization, so many eyes before you saw this eyes come from your mouth out. with breath. Do you feel if you are in your room, the room is completely full hours, you know? Like the children, they're blue, you know, they can be also for houses for this. And then slowly, and then after you want to break, you finish, and then you can, you say, and then you feel all the eyes coming back to you. Then the whole body like become like ah. And then this before ah is goes to, then dissolves into your heart. The heart inside, you feel like this is visualization, if you like. Mm-hmm. And then the last ah is become is white light. The white light dissolves into you, or you become as light. Your body and your mind completely is, you know? And they coming back as you, and then you can dedication some, if you have some prayers, and then also if you have nothing to read, and then you can good wishes, all the things you need, how many minutes you meditate, and these virtues I want to offer or giving to the, all the saints and beings. So that is I have done, you know. And that is so much accumulation merit for you. Huh? So that is you can, if you like.
Yeah? Maybe it'd be useful, Rinpoche, just to say about whether you, when you say concentrating, sometimes maybe people think it's staring. Maybe you could say something about the nature of the gaze. I think is mm-hmm. is that difficult for you?
Yes, yeah. Because my focus.
Yeah.
Yeah. It you can gaze.
Are you relaxing,
you your,
or are you? Can you say something about when you're doing the concentration practice with your eyes,
mm-hmm.
looking at something?
Right.
What is your tell? What are your gaze like? Is it a strong gaze, or is it a very relaxed gaze? Because I think this is.
Uh-huh.
A problem, isn't it, for you?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Can you describe, are you looking like,
yeah,
yeah. Can you say something on that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. You, only the object of your eyes, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Just look, not strongly, or, for example, if I look here, all there's maybe bird, and you know, there's some region, and dodge, I don't know how many you can say. And there's 30 or 330 kilometers, or you know, that is detail. Then you checking and the object, not focusing, right? Yeah. And you just look, at the bottle here, and roughly, yeah, roughly to there. You don't need, make distinction. Well, there's the flowers, and there's you know different ways. You know, you don't need to do that. Just focus to look. You can do that? Yeah, surely.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so even if you have some flowers like this, you know, and if you are home, some people have, doesn't matter if you are plastic flowers in the home, and you can look just this flower and focusing. You know, you don't need the details or the all the leaves, so maybe they have five, you know, and six, so you don't need to do this, just focus, no? Yeah? So when you visualization, then you need visualization as Buddha or images, because then you have to see details, the eyes, because the element, because this is makes pure perception,
mm-hmm.
not only focusing, no? This is for realization, how it's how the Buddhas be and how you be also, you know?
Mm-hmm.
You understand that, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yeah, I wanted to say about this, when you're like visualizing and you're like focusing on an object, your mind always tries to identify the object.
Mm-hmm.
You see the colors, the shape, and
mm-hmm.
maybe some other things around it.
Mm-hmm.
But is it better than to be like, if first you always identify it, it's impossible because your mind is not possible to say like it's nothing because you
mm-hmm.
see.
Right.
Is it better than to have it like in an abstract phase after you identify that and become more attached from it than instead of like going all the way into it?
Because
mm-hmm. if you really focus on something, then your mind starts rolling like, oh, it's
right.
blue, I can, oh,
mm-hmm.
it's maybe China blue, or
mm-hmm.
it's like the ocean, or like,
right.
it keeps on rolling and rolling,
yeah.
then maybe it's better than just stop at a certain point and say, like, it's just that,
mm-hmm.
that it's there.
Right. If you go to deeply, you know, deeply focusing, I think then it's like the Om, that is better. Because there's kind of energy and images, you know, or symbolic. And this just focusing, it doesn't matter. Whatever you can focus in, just look at the what you see, you know. Not mix like identify or what is that, what is this, you know, to something. But if you want to identify your own mind, and then we have to analyze, experiment my emotion, my thinking, goes to back, you know, without the object. We have to identify our own, which is our subject, which is our own mind. That is we can identify. Yeah? Because we have to recognize really what is my mind, no? Not only focusing. That is before I said, what's the difference is we have the mindfulness. The Buddhism way is more, is realization, not only focusing. That is difference, right? Our common mindfulness is focusing because our mind, the busy, normally is busy head or the thinking, or also we are busy in the life. So we have stress, you know, sometimes depressed, sometimes panic, fear, worry, all these things because our mind is not focusing because too much for the head, no? And this is, we focus on one point, this is can help our mind is relaxing and rest and calm, you know? That is benefit, different way. And what you said, I think the identify of mind, that is our object, the mind, you know? And that is very important. This then we go to really deep meditation, you know, deep meditation, which is really not only focusing, but it's realization, understanding the nature of the mind, right? So that is a deeper thing. So, yeah, you understand? This makes sense.
Yes.
Oh.
I have a question,
yeah?
Rinpoche.
Mm-hmm.
What do you experience when your mind is calm?
My person.
Yes.
Yeah. This, of course, beginning I try to meditate. Yeah, and I receive a teaching from. He passed away a few years ago, maybe no one knows. But anyway, so one of master in Tibet, he teaching Dzogchen always, Dzogchen teaching. He's Dzogchen master. And I was very young, and but I received the teaching of Dzogchen from him, and then I have a friend, young monk. And then the teaching is in the, of course, in Tibet, the natural place, and they make chant, and we're teaching in the tent. We have no house like this, and everybody sleeping in the tent, 10, 20 people together. And there's no toilet, no shower.
Mm-hmm.
That is the nature, true nature.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So anyway, so this, but sometimes it's so enjoy. It's beautiful, the natural place, you know, whole mountains and the grass, like the grasses grow up, you know, so much flowers and beautiful. And then after the teaching finished, and this my friend, the young monk, and we walk the other side. It's very beautiful, and we walk there. And then of course the sun shining. It's a very beautiful weather and a very beautiful place. And the grasses grow up and the flowers grow up. Very beautiful in summertime. And then we walk there, and finally I thought, okay, now we received Dzogchen teaching, but we have to meditate. You know, I told him, my friend, and he also young. I'm also was a young boy, and he said, yeah, he's lacking because we don't know how to meditate. You know, too young. And then I was very seriously. I'm thinking, and we should do, you know, because otherwise why we receive teachings? You know, we have to practice. You know? And I say seriously, seriously to him, we have to practice. He said, okay, yes, we can. And we sit there and try to meditate. And then, of course, sitting is very easy, no problem, as what he said, the teacher said. But then, when you close the eyes, the mind, I have no idea how to meditate. Even I don't know what really meditation meaning. What do you do? It's not easy, either. Just sitting there, and he is laughing, but I think he also don't know. You know, like this, we started, you know. And then I listened again, many teachings about doctrine and other, of course, then there's the other things. And then slowly, I couldn't manage how to meditate, what is meditation means, is like, you know. Slowly, and then if you know a little bit, and then you practice, you have to practice, meditate, and then slowly the mind is working, a function, the how to meditate. And then slowly, before also, when I was young, also I have kind of a panic. I don't know why, but it's some kind of not really relax my mind, sometimes little fear, it's kind of panic, I can say. That this is I have. But then I used to meditate, a kind of learning from my teachers. And then, slowly, it's gone. The panic is gone. Yeah, more, now it's more and more, it's relaxing my mind. Because the meditation helps a lot. That is my own experience, you know. And then I think everybody is the same when you use meditation, and not only sitting meditation, but I think mostly it's understanding how to do. That's very important. If you know how to do, meditate, and then if you're sitting, if you're walking, if you're eating, if you sleep, always you can do. You understand, the meditation. Even you go to sleep, like before I said, you know, you go to sleep, but you look like sleep, but your mind is put in meditation place, level. That means it's you always relax and peace and put your mind, nature of your mind is yourself. I said itself. Or I used always come back home. That is, for me, it's very important for my meaning. Because our mind is not home, running out. You know, I think the mind coming back home means is being self. And that is really big meaning for me. And then it's the same way where you go to sleep and you meditate. As the meditation level, you're going to sleep. And then almost whole night you can go to this level. It's possible, you know. And, but this is we need a little bit more experience, no? So yes, like that. Rinpoche,
I think we almost have to break because I think we skipped the break a little bit. Mm-hmm. So my suggestion is that we slowly closing down, and then the break will go on into the dinner. So then, because otherwise,
dinner.
Yeah, it's almost 11:45 now, and lunch. Sorry, and the lunch is already 12:30. So I think, and I think people, they need to have to go to toilet. But no. Maybe you can give a small advice to us now how to, when we go to the dinner or to the lunch, how to deal, because the lunch is in silence, how we can practice the mindfulness in the break and in the lunch.
Yes, yeah. Okay. I think when you eat, the mindfulness, first of all, it's motivation. The motivation, you know, beginning when we start eating. Because when we eat, the food is come from somewhere else. You know, the food is come from something else. Of course, for food, someone worked so hard for this to get the food, right? One thing's like that. And the second level is the food is come from in the nature. Yeah? I mean, maybe in the field, but we today we are the vegetables, right? I think so, yeah? And we don't eat meat, so if we eat meat, then another subject's there, right? But we are vegetable today, we eat vegetables. So, and then it's the motivation. When you start to eat the food, and then if you have prayer, this is the Buddhist monks also always pray before you eat, and the prayer, the food prayer, is one thing, is they calling is blessing the food. Yeah? And secondly, it's not only blessing the food, but it's praying for the who work this for the food. And even the monks get food is from someone give, someone offering you. And the praying is focusing the motivation to is grateful to give the food, and is prayer to who give the food, and to that person. I mean, this is prayer. That is like kind of thank you, but it's more than it's prayer for him or for her. That is in the monastery every we do this for prayer. Huh? This is always wish a good life and healthy, and you know, that is the good wishes, the imaginary. And they saying some prayers also, something the prayers also saying the who give the food. And this is the first motivation we should do, no? And secondly, and then when you eat, you know, when you eat, you know, you eat also, eating not only for my stomach to full or to feed on myself, but this is a motivation. And because we are today, we practice and mentally aware, which is mental positive action, you know. And when you eat the food, and you eat, for all who other sentient beings who is the hungry, you eat for them. Yeah? And that is you imagine. Yeah? And then you eat a spoon going to, it's the same way. Now mindfulness is when you put food in your mouth, then you have to choosing. No? And then when you then you focus on what you're eating, you know, you cook. And then you swallow, it's the same way, mindfulness, you swallow the food. And the same way, like this. Then after finish, you finish. And then and when you finish the food, and then also dedication. Then also kind of thank you, and food. I'm really happy, enjoy to eat this food. At the same time, I wish all others who has no food, and they also satisfy, enjoy, I eat for them. That is kind of prayer and dedication. Ultimately, you know, getting better life like this. Yeah? This is focus. Yeah? That is what we can do. Right?
Yes. Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So we have lunch. I will ring the bell, and then we have 1 hour for the lunch. The lunch is a warm meal, and yeah, when you finish, we eat together. But let's see if there's a dessert. You can prepare or have your own time, and then exactly at 13:30. So in English it's 1:30 p.m. We gather on the back side in front of the big garden. So not the front, but the back. You can enter in one of the corridors. And I know, I think nice green place. We can walk, it's very short. So mm-hmm. if we gather there, then yeah, we wait for you. We can leave at 1:30 p.m. and leave on the back side because there's a very nice green area here. So
the weather is nice.
We never know. Everything is changing or emptiness. Or I don't know. But it's maybe good to put on good shoes. Good shoes.
If that's possible. Mm-hmm. Maybe
and
parapluie.
And maybe a parapluie.
Can we leave the pillows behind? Can you leave it here?
Yeah, you can. Everything okay? More questions or practical things?
Is it also kind of
Is it muddy? No, not so. But we walk also on grass, but it's not quite a lot of mud.
Okay.